thank you all. I did some to Mr. Pan. FFA teams compete at several points during the year. We are recognizing several tonight for winning honors at district and at regionals. Many of them will be going on to the state event at Virginia Tech in June. Included in that group are from the senior FFA forestry team, Aaron Perry, Cheyenne Schaefer, Chris Robinette, and Andy Perry. From the junior FFA forestry team, Caleb Brannick, Emily Gray, Richard Hairston, Tanner Roach. Emily Gray also won first in the region for her Creed speaking. The FFA veterinary science team included Cheyenne Schaefer, Kaylee Smith, Aaron Perry, and Chris Robinette. And the FFA nursery and landscape team also winning first in the region, Tanner Roach, Caleb Brannick, Sarah Wilson, and Emily Westmoreland. Area, so I'm going to give them to Mr. Holland. Everybody ready? As you know, at our last evening meeting, we were able to recognize the Bassett State swimmers, and Magna Vista had an event that evening. So we asked Caitlin Brown to join us tonight so that we could recognize her. She placed first in the 100-meter backstroke and second in the 100-meter freestyle at the region, and placed 15th in the 100-meter backstroke and 15th in the 100-meter freestyle in the region as well. We also had some students compete at the state level for forensics this semester. Winning the state forensics competition for humorous duo from Magna Vista High School was Carissa Bethel and Marianne Booth. They were fourth in the state for their area. And I have not seen those ladies this evening, so I think they were unable to join us. Have a couple other students from Magna Vista who are here with us, and they just this weekend won the state bass fishing championships. Second place winners were Devin Page and Nick Page. We also had two groups of students compete on the state level at the DECA competition this semester. From Bassett High School, Mackenzie Reynolds and Zakiya Kidd received a third place finish for their business proposal for a school-based enterprise. Their presentation included the opportunities that existed at Bassett High School. They presented their idea for a vending machine that held school apparel and school supplies. The business would be managed and run by DECA and marketing students. They were recognized at the closing awards ceremony on stage at the conference in Virginia Beach in March. Mackenzie's with us tonight, and I'm going to ask her to stay up front for just a moment. From Magna Vista, Tyler Tuggle qualified for the state leadership conference held on March 3rd in Virginia Beach. Tyler didn't qualify for the International Leadership Career Development Conference, but he was a first place winner and was recognized at the state level for having one of the top scores on one of his competitive role plays. We also had some students to earn a place in the All-State Chorus this semester, which is a high distinction for any student across the state. We're proud to say that we have three students who made that list. From Bassett High School, Isaiah Young. From Magna Vista High School, Josh Perliman and Abigail Shelton. Young men earned the distinction of being part of the All-State Band. Jake Gussler, Sullivan Higgins, and Will Stone from Bassett High School were part of that group. Student groups, the Magna Vista Indoor Track and Field members who made it to state competition are Dakoya Carter, Samina Olds, Zakiya King, Kiana Tinsley, Jordan Hairston, Sierra Moore, and Caitlin Kidd for the girls team, and from the boys team, Devin Dillard, Jaquan Perkins, Taj Clanton, Rondarian Smith, and Chris Ross. Thank you all. My final award of the evening is actually presented to you, the Henry County School Board. Each year, we compete in the Digital School District Survey, which is part of the Center for Digital Education competition held at the National School Board Association Conference. And this year, Henry County Public Schools was again recognized as a school district of distinction in the Digital School District Survey Awards.
Let's come on.
Thank you very much.
We often tell people how good we are, and Michael's a good opportunity to show the world how good we are. Let's give everybody another round of applause. I'd like to thank not only the students that participated, but also the coaches, the teachers, the parents, everyone that was involved. This is something that we need to continue to shoot for. Shoot for the stars. Mike, they all worked up. Okay. Next is on information agenda update on Bellevue Elementary School.
Good evening, Mr. Chairman, members of the school board. It's hard to follow that with all the awards going, but I will share with you some good news for Meadowview. Things are moving along in a good rate. Some interior framing is complete on both floors in Wing A, which are the classroom areas. All the concrete floors have been poured on both upper floor and lower floor on Wings A and B. The roofing on that Wing A is 100% complete and about 70% complete on Wing B. And again, as I've posted these, of course, things are happening pretty fast, so we're just about 100% complete now on Wing B by the time I'm giving you this update. The brick installation has begun on Wing A. They're kind of moving that around the side of the wings to kind of get them a layout around the whole building. The cornice, which is the overhang around the building, has begun on both the Wings A, B, and the gym area. Bar joist installation in the gym is in place, and the metal roof decking is just about complete. The bar joist in the media center is in place and waiting for metal decking. We have all the trades that continue, as we've talked about before, working on A and B to include all the HVAC, electrical, plumbing, etc. The final grade on site work is taking place and will continue once the weather allows. They've been working in between some of this heavy rain that we've had as well. So, any questions or where we are at this point?
Have the recent rain set us back in?
Just from the site work standpoint, the good side is pretty much everything was dried in, so the trades continue to have 60 to 70 people up there do every day. The only thing it delays is the site work, which we've got a little bit of room on that. We weren't anticipating all that to be done until September anyway. So.
Okay. What about steps?
Steps are one set is on site. They're just about ready to start installing the first set on Wing A. Thank you.
Our next item is change in middle school mathematics. Ms. Holmberg.
Good evening, Chairman Milner, members of the school board. I am here tonight to present you guys with some information about a new middle school math course that will be implemented in August, this coming up school year. It's going to be called Integrated Math 7, and the purpose of this class is to take the place of students taking Algebra 1 in the 7th grade. There before you, I have some points. The reason that we thought that this was the best avenue was so that students receive the basic math concepts that they actually miss by taking Algebra 1 in the 7th grade. For example, integer operations, fractions, decimals, percents, real-life math skills, they actually miss those by taking Algebra 1 in the 7th grade. And ultimately, and most importantly, we're hoping to firm up the foundation of those math students so that when they get to their sophomore, junior year, that will strengthen and increase our SAT and our ACT scores at the high school level. So that is our intention with this new class. They actually have no exposure when they enter Algebra 1 in the seventh grade into the verbal, visual, analytical relationships of functions. They also have no concept of solving or graphing multi-step equations prior to taking geometry, which is all application-based. They do not get any of the basics. The surface area and volume is minimal at best, and there is no exposure to three-dimensional objects. So we're hoping that with this integrated math course, they will get those basic fundamental concepts before they go on to higher level mathematics. Now, one question that you may receive, that we may receive, is my child will not be able to take classes in the ACE program or Governor's School. That is not the case at all, at all. Also before you, I have a course progression chart that you can follow. Every student in Henry County Public Schools will be able to choose the path that's best for them. Even if they take Math 6 in the 6th grade, Math 7 in the 7th grade, Math 8 in the 8th grade, they can still, by making wise choices when they sign up for their classes, they will still be able to set themselves up to be able to apply for Governor's School in the spring of their 10th grade year, as well as the ACE program. So this is not doing anything to hurt our students. This is only to make our students stronger mathematically. And again, every course progression, we've worked together to come up with every scenario possible, and every student in Henry County Public Schools has the opportunity to take care of those upper level math classes if they so choose. By doubling up in their math first semester and second semester, which is actually the way they do it at Governor's School and in the ACE program at both of our high schools. Do you have any questions at all that I can help you with?
I think you've answered the main question I would have had about being able to qualify for the ACE program or Governor's School, and then I'm
yes, sir. Yes, sir, I was.
Not a math teacher. I'm often worried about students who took Algebra 1 too soon, and then by the 10th grade they had finished up all the math they needed and went 2 years without a math, and then went into college having not had a math course in 2 years. This seems to address that.
That was our intention. Just coming out of the math classroom teaching juniors and seniors, that was a recommendation that I made, and we worked, as I said, the curriculum team, we worked together because we don't want to hinder any student. We actually want to push all our students as far as they can go with this progression, and I think mathematically this is the best way to address that and make a strong math student coming out of Henry County Public Schools. That's my number one goal for this. Any other questions?
It also addresses a concern we hear sometimes that kids don't know anything about fractions now.
Yes.
Because they don't see them much once you get
absolutely
into higher math.
Yes, sir. That was actually something that I saw in the classroom teaching seniors in upper level mathematics that they did not understand the basic fundamentals. So this hopefully will address it with this blended curriculum from 7th and 8th grade.
Ms. Barry, I wanted to make sure that they saw the matrix that they have in front of them.
Yes.
Students will be selected for the integrated math course if they are obviously advanced in the 6th grade math class, and this matrix will be used to select students for that and keep it because they're going to be addressing 7th and 8th grade mathematics in 1 year. So obviously you want students that can address that successfully during the 7th grade year, and then those students will take Algebra 1 in 8th grade. But again, what we've learned is they skip in some cases 2 years of mathematics, and there are a lot of Mrs. Perry being here before you is because she taught geometry, mm-hmm. and she found those gaps.
There were lots.
They arrived in geometry class and calculus, and she had to go back and reteach. So we're hoping that, that this will build a stronger math student.
Absolutely.
Any other questions? Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you for your time.
Next item is the consent agenda. On the consent agenda, we have approval of minutes from April 6, 2017, monthly meeting at April 18, 2017, contingent meeting, and item B, approval of bills for payment. What's your pleasure on those consent agenda?
Mr. Chairman, I move we approve the consent agenda as presented.
Second. The motion is second that we approve the consent agenda as presented. All in favor, indicate by raising your right hand. Thank you. I'm going to ask you all to forgive me. It's sitting here all night and looking over there and failed to recognize Mr. Martin. Mr. Martin, stand up. First fight on the job, new school board member. Let's give a round of applause. Okay, action agenda. First item is approval of updates to certain school board policies on second reading. I think we have Mrs. Kleinman.
Good evening, Mr. Chairman and members of the board. The proposed policy revisions for this evening reflect efforts to bring policies into compliance with new or existing laws and regulations, or in some cases have been revised for editorial reasons. The revisions are provided in a format showing each change made to the policies. Changes are designated by underlining new language and striking through deleted language. Policy revisions have been verified for legality by the Virginia School Boards Association. Policies can be found on board docs under the featured tab Policies Under Consideration. We did provide a summary of the policy changes at last month's meeting. Tonight, the revisions are being presented as a second reading, and it is recommended that the revisions be approved as presented. Are there any questions?
I think you answered our question last time that all of these are in keeping with the state changes to policy.
They are.
I advance the motion that this policy updates be approved as presenting.
Second. Motion is second that the updates be approved as presented. Any further discussion? All in favor, indicate by raising your right hand. Thank you. No.
Thank you.
Next item we have is approval of FY17 budget categorical transfer appropriation request. Additional appropriation is lost.
Good evening, Mr. Chairman and members of the board. It's that time of year when we start looking at our revenues and expenditures to see if we have funds available to complete purchases that we put on hold to make sure we have money if an emergency arises during the year and to ensure we don't overspend our budget. We've determined that a transfer from administration attendance and health to the technology category would be beneficial for the 2017 budget. And these funds are needed to help with year-end purchases and ongoing budgetary needs. An additional transfer from the operations and maintenance category to the facilities category is necessary to supplement the 2016 carry forward to complete phase four of the Bassett High School project. Excuse me. We've seen a continued increase in the number of students registering for dual enrollment courses, which is a good thing. Now for the spring semester, we're due to receive a reimbursement in the amount of $478,302.34. We are requesting an additional appropriation in the amount of $39,324,000 for dual enrollment. And our last item, insurance reimbursements received in excess of our original budget for insurance adjustments for claims related to vehicle incidents and damage by others to our property totaled $36,138. For 2017. We're requesting additional appropriation be made to cover assisting the repairs of our budget. It's recommended that the school board approve the categorical transfer request of $264,000 and approve additional appropriations of $75,462 and forward a transfer appropriation request to the Board of Supervisors.
You've heard Ms. Lawson's presentation. What's your pleasure?
The money that we received back from Patrick Henry for dual enrollment, mm-hmm. that's money that we, that comes to them from the state and then comes back to us. How does that work exactly?
Let Sandy help me on that one, Mr. Stryker. So actually what happens is we enroll the students in a dual enrollment course, and then PH bills us for every credit hour the students take in dual enrollment. And then PH will reimburse us money based on the credentials of our teachers. If our teachers are fully credentialed, they reimburse us 100%. If our teachers are not fully credentialed, they assign an adjunct professor to work with our teacher that's teaching the dual enrollment subject, and they only reimburse us 70%. So that's how.
But that allows all the students who meet the requirements to earn the college credit.
Yes, sir. Any student that passes the Virginia placement test and signs up for dual enrollment is allowed to take it. And yes, sir, that's happened. We have a large number of students who do qualify and want to go ahead and receive these college credits before entering college.
It's very challenging to budget for that because we do our best to make sure that we have credentialed, certified teachers so that we get the highest reimbursement. But in some cases, we can't hire a teacher for that credential, so we get a different reimbursement. The other challenge is, rather than just getting a bill, you know, we pay and we get reimbursed. So it would probably be better just to be paid outright or just billed outright. But it is challenging the way that we have to work the process. So we try really hard to narrow down that amount, but we also don't want to limit students from the opportunity. So we do have some parameters, but any given year, you have different courses that are more popular than others, so we have some flexibility.
And we actually did increase our budget on this line item, but we've exceeded what we increased it by. Mm-hmm.
Do you have a ballpark figure of how many kids are earning college credit for you? Off the top of your head.
We actually, as Don says, every year it's increased, so we projected this year based on our BPT scores that it would be much higher, and that's why she did increase the funds. But I can get you that number for this
meeting.
I can get you an actual number.
We had a number in our budget presentation for last year. I don't know what that was.
Because, you know, we have those students who earn an associate's degree. We have many of those that earn those. All the A students earn that. Several of the governor school students take extra classes and earn that. But we have many students that are taking. But I will get you a definite number.
We can get the last few years, so mm-hmm. we'll send that to you.
Well, based on that excellent explanation, I'll advance a motion that the categorical transfers be approved as requested.
I have a question for Mr. Lyle. As a Patrick Henry Community College employee, do I need to abstain from the entire vote or just from that provision?
I don't think you need, all right, let me think about this for a second. You work for the college.
Yes.
You're paying for the college. You can just abstain from that. We'll ask your question one more time.
Do I need to abstain from the entire vote or just that particular provision as a college employee?
Just that particular provision.
Okay.
I second this motion. The motion is second that we approve the FY 2017 budget categorical transfer appropriation and request additional appropriation. Any further discussion? All in favor, if you raise your right hand. Item C, approval and appropriation of 2017-18 special education annual plan Part B flow through application. And Section 619, issue grant application.
Good evening, Mr. Chairman and members of the board. That was a mouthful. I'm really sorry about that, but I don't have a cool little short title. So I'm here to discuss with you tonight our flow-through application that we present each year. Our IDEA awards projected for fiscal year 2017 is $2,025,755. It is an increase over the 16-17 amount, and that is based on our child count from over the past couple years. It takes a couple years for it to catch up. Our child count increased in December from last year's 1,037 to this year's 1,060, and we actually have several more students since that was sent in December. Our final award notification is slated to arrive around July 2017. We also have an estimated proportionate set aside funds of $18,258 that will come out of that $2 million. That is an increase of approximately $4,415.99 from last year, and that was because of some of the reporting that we did. There were a couple extra students we found that we had to report. Proportionate set aside actually serves our students that are parentally privately placed. It's a Carlisle, or if they choose to homeschool, and we provide those students with services, which is only speech. But we do, that is set aside for those students, and it is 100% grant funded. Our 6B personnel currently paid out of the grant are 23 highly qualified teachers and 15 highly qualified paraprofessionals, and this budget reflects the 2% increase for classified employees as well as the two-step increase for teachers. And also the program summer staff is covered by the grant as well. Our balance forward funds from 2016-2017 6B grant funds will be used to fund services on the next few pages or the next few slides that you will see. And those include, but are not limited to, medical examinations, extended school year field experiences, our Viva Music program, which you guys had the pleasure of experiencing in an earlier board meeting this year, a behavioral specialist, computerized IEP management system, which actually we will be what they call championing the new statewide IEP system. Our division was chosen for that, so we will be piloting that, which is actually through the same program we use now, independent living skills and training, orientation mobility services, and additional professional development. We also have child find activities, parental involvement activities, speech services for the parentally placed private school students, as I referenced for the proportionate set-aside. Teacher materials and supplies, assistive technology devices, iPads, computers, and FM systems. We're also in the business of supporting college and career readiness through augmentative communication, READ 180 System 44, post-secondary education rehabilitation transition course to Woodrow Wilson, community-based curriculum and EMI, which is at the John D. Bassett Center, transition planning, self-determination, and the Southern Virginia Youth Expo. Our additional award we have is Project 619, and this is the preliminary pre-K award, our early childhood special education. That will be $82,037, and that's 100% grant funded as well. And out of that award, our programs and services include one early childhood special education teacher, summer program services, preschool conferences, workshops, training, educational supplies and materials, student enrichment experiences, child find activities and parental involvement, as well as equipment, computers, and furniture. And this plan was presented to the Special Education Parent Advisory Committee and approved by them on April 10th, 2017. Do you guys have any questions?
Chairman, I move we approve Mrs. Root's request as presented.
Second. The motion is second that we approve for the approval and appropriation of the 2017-18 Special Education Annual Plan, Part B, flow-through application of Section 619 Preschool Grant Application. Is there any further discussion? All in favor, let me take a raise my hand. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good evening, Mr. Chairman, members of the board. Since 2015, we've been provided with certified athletic trainers at Bassett and Magna Vista on behalf of Memorial Hospital of Martinsville and Henry County. His trainers work with coaches and athletes to provide not only practice and event coverage, but injury management, injury prevention, concussion awareness, and management. The trainers have treated approximately 201 injuries since 2015. They've ranged in severity from minor to needing surgery and months of formal physical therapy. It's recommended that the school board approve certified athletic trainers for the 2017-18 school year and that the division be authorized to exercise subsequent renewals in accordance with terms of the contract with Memorial Hospital of Martinsville and Henry County, RFP 17-04183A190. The fiscal impact of this will be $36,000, which is $18,000 per school. For the fiscal year 2018 budget, instructional purchases services, or fiscal year 2017 budget pending year-end funds. Any questions?
Now, we did say that the athletic trainers would be on hand for all athletic events, or?
They are on hand at all high school athletic events, practices included.
Practices?
Yes, ma'am.
In terms of individual trainers, the hospital is ultimately who hires them, is that correct?
Yes, sir, that's correct.
Okay. And are they employees of the hospital, or are these in training? Are these athletic trainers that are finishing degree work?
No, sir, they've already finished their degree work. We do have a working relationship with some that are coming in from other universities who have been trained or are being trained going through their educational process.
Motion second that we approve the certified athletic trainers for both Bassett Magnus House. Further discussion. All in favor, indicate by raising your right hand.
Thank you.
Next, we have approval to purchase EP3 core and expansion sets and software for Lego Education. Ms. Dunn.
Good evening, Chairman Milner and members of the board. In order to stay up to date with the latest technology, and to assist students in meeting state competencies, it is important to replace and expand the technology used in the CTE classes. With the purchase of four EV3 core expansion sets and the accompanying software, the technology classes at Field O'Collinsville and Laura Park Middle School will be equipped with instructional resources that allow students to enhance their critical thinking and creativity skills. Each set contains everything needed to teach beginning STEM and computer science. The kit offers full teacher support, including STEM and computing teaching materials, and a comprehensive e-learning program. The system also includes the EV3 Intelligent Brick, which is a compact and powerful programmable computer that makes it possible to control motors and collect sensor feedback using the intuitive icon-based programming and data logging software. It is recommended that the school board approve the purchase of the four EV3 core expansion sets and software for the career and technical education technology classes at both middle schools. The physical impact is $31,261.53, and it's 100% reimbursable through the Carl Perkins grant.
I like that.
they do that for you every time.
Motion second to approve the purchase of EV3 core and expansion sets of software for middle education. Any further discussion? All in favor, please raise your right hand. Now, Ms. Thank you.
Thank you.
Next, we have approval of the lease of iPads and laptops for students and staff. Ms. Patrick.
Good evening, Chairman Milner and members of the board. The school division established a sustainability plan to ensure that all iPads and computers are on a four-year lease renewal program. With this program, devices are replaced every 4 years so students and staff have up-to-date technology. Currently, middle school teachers are in the second year of the lease, and high school teachers are in the third year of the lease. Elementary teachers will begin a new lease for the fiscal year 2018. Grades 3 through 5, 7, and 8 have currently leased iPads. Sixth grade students will begin a new lease for the fiscal year 2018. New Tech Academy students have currently leased laptop computers. Ninth grade students will begin a new lease for the 2018 fiscal year. This recommendation is to start and renew all technology leases for the upcoming fiscal year 2018. It is recommended that the school board approve the start and renewal leases of iPads and laptops for iPads for students, laptops for New Tech Academy students, and laptops for staff. The fiscal impact is an estimated $450,000. This is out of the 2018 technology budget.
This is that it's not far away from being a problem having every device at least, you know, a few years away.
We're not that far. I spoke with the Apple rep today, and we're trying to combine some leases, and we expect to have the quote.
The goal is to get all devices on.
Yes.
And as we've discussed, that's why you continue to see that as a budgetary item, because our goal is to get every device on a lease so that we have a replacement cycle built in. That way we don't have to hope for year-end money to replace with one-time money, because that's not sustainable. Because some years we don't have money to replace. So our goal is to get everything on a lease, so that's why you continue to see that as one of the priorities when we do our budget to work on this over time. We knew it would take us about 3 or 4 years. But this seems to me like the second year of the plan. I'm looking over at Tayway. Maybe there's 2 more years after this. Am I correct on that?
That's correct.
Sounds right. Okay.
Chairman, I so move that we make the lease of the iPads and the laptops.
Second. The motion is second that we approve the lease of iPads and laptops for students and staff. And further discussion. All in favor, indicate by raising your right hand. You're still up.
Yeah.
Okay. Who will purchase cases for new 6th grade iPads?
Continuing with the IT sustainability and replacement cycle, this school year the division hopes to replace the 6th grade iPads with the new iPad. The cases that we wish to purchase are very sturdy and support the iPad as it travels home in a book bag. The new case includes a cover in addition to a 3-year zero deductible repair warranty. Rugged, the company, will also repair the iPad screen if it is damaged inside the case. That's part of the warranty. It is recommended that the school board approve the purchase of 600 iPad cases at $69 each from Rugged, who is sole source for the Rugged case. This will have a fiscal impact of $41,400 from fiscal year 2018 budget or fiscal year 2017 pending year-end funds.
Members of the board, I understand you saw the case last year when Tayway did a nice little demonstration of throwing it on the floor. The iPad survived. But the good news is we've only had one cracked case or glass.
Just one iPad broken inside a case this year.
So that tells me that it's a good case. It's strong. So.
Second. So the motion second will be approved the purchase of cases for new 6th grade iPads and public discussion. All in favor, if you're ready to bring them in. Thank you. Approval to purchase OLED. Am I pronouncing that right? OLED.
Follett School Solutions is the sole source provider of Destiny Library Manager, Resource Manager, Textbook Manager, and Resource Deployment Services. On the hosted environment of Destiny Library Manager, students can access research material and book inventory anytime, anywhere. With the Resource Manager, this provides an accurate inventory of all digital equipment in order to manage the sustainability plan. The Textbook Manager allows staff to track textbook inventory in order to plan for classes based on student population. The Deployment Service, which is one-time fee, which would be this year, facilitates Follett technicians that will be responsible for setting up Follett equipment and downloading and configuring Follett software and tagging all assets. It is recommended that the school board approve the purchase of Follett Library Manager, Resource Manager, Textbook Manager, and Resource Deployment Services. This has a fiscal impact of $105,560.13 from fiscal year 2018 technology purchase services or fiscal year 2017 pending year-end funds.
And I understand that this will free up our media special, so they will not have to do this. Great conversation.
Yes, sir. My hope is the resource deployment amount for $67,452 is a good use of one-time funds because the pilot organization will contract to have folks come out and inventory all of our devices and put labels on them and make sure they're all accounted for. If we don't have the funds to do this, then that falls on staff, which could be our media specialist. So I would prefer to use this for one-time funds so that we can get everything in inventory. We really need a better system to make sure that everything's accounted for, and that's why we feel this is an important initiative that we've been talking about for a whole year, that we're finally ready to make a recommendation.
I'd also like to add, when speaking with them yesterday, they're going to contract about 30 employees, and they're going to do it through our Ameristaff and train our community members that apply. So they've asked that we also look at the list, and if we have employees that would like to do it, if we have our own librarians or any employees in our school system, that they will agree to employ them. For 9 days. This is a 9-day project this summer.
So is this place the old thing that we used to have to go through hands-on and identify every technology piece to ensure that we still have?
Yes, it will be like a Walmart scanner. We'll just scan everything, and then we'll be able to track all of our inventory from one database.
I make a motion that we approve to purchase Violet Destiny Library Management System.
Second. The motion is second that we approve the purchase of Violet Destiny Library Management System. All in favor, if you raise your right hand. Next, we have approval to purchase Pearson Connex online learning platform for 2017-18.
Pearson Connexus is the sole source provider for courseware that combines online sources with uniquely designed online lessons. These courses will be utilized by students at risk of not graduating, on homebound, or in need of an alternative study in order to be successful. It is recommended that the school board approve the purchase of Pearson Connexus, a sole source blended online learning platform for the 2017-18 school year. This will have a fiscal impact of $33,380 from fiscal year 2018 instructional purchase services budget or fiscal year 2017 pending year-end funds and from the Breaking Barriers Grant for Regional Alternative Program.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, this is expanding our online blended learning program. You're going to start hearing more about the virtual HCPS, is that what we're doing?
Yes, virtual
and
HCPS.
As well as the Success Academy, what we're doing is providing some online blended learning opportunities for students, not only at CCL, where students who are very far behind at the end of 10th grade can make up courses through course acceleration or recovery, but also students at each high school be able to go to the media center and pick up a course online throughout the semester to help them either catch up or take the course so that they'll open up their schedule to take a wonderful choir or music course or band course or I see one of our teachers out there, so that it opens up their schedule to do other things. So we're really trying to create more flexibility and you'll hear more about that as we move forward. We're also allowing students to take courses in the summer.
And this will improve our on-time graduation rate?
Yes, sir. That is exactly one of the main reasons we're doing this, because we should not be waiting until senior year to talk about, I'm sorry, I'm graduating. At the end of 10th grade, we have a number of students that are well behind that we need to address as soon as possible. We can't wait. So this is a big part of that, and I know Mike Minner is here, and he's been working.
Chairman, members of the board, may the fourth be with you. As we continue with our infrastructure upgrade to provide adequate coverage and bandwidth to all schools, a bid was issued with three vendors responding. Of the three firms responding, ESI Electronic Systems Incorporated of Roanoke, Virginia, was the lowest with a total bid of $338,851.25. The bid was issued in conjunction with our filing for E-rate funding for the 2017-18 school year. The division can request networking equipment such as access points for each classroom and switches for the school network. This year we are requesting equipment for the following elementary schools: Axton Elementary, Drury Mason Elementary, G.W. Carver Elementary, Meadowview Elementary, and Sandville Elementary, and Stanleytown Elementary, for an estimated 307 access points and 26 switches. This will complete our planned network infrastructure upgrade for all schools. It is recommended that the school board award the bid number 17-04073-3004 to ESI of Roanoke, Virginia, and approve the purchase of equipment needed to complete the infrastructure upgrade. Estimated $47,905.10.
Any questions? The remainder of that will be paid by the E-rate reimbursement?
Correct. The $47,905 is our 20% share. And of course, it's not 20% of that 338. That was just the bid. When we issued the bid, it was for all elementary schools, but three of the elementary schools will be funded this year.
Mr. Chairman, I move that we make a purchase of the upgrade network infrastructure at the elementary schools.
Second.
Motion second that we approve the bid upgrade network infrastructure at elementary schools. Any further discussion? All in favor, indicate by raising right hand.
Thank you.
Approval to purchase additional furniture for Bingo Tech Academy. Mr. Keith Scott.
Good evening again, Mr. Chairman, members of the school board. As we, Bingo Tech, gets ready to welcome a new class next year, we're looking at wanting to purchase some more furniture for these new students as they come in. As you know, the Bingo Tech Academy focuses on developing a culture which promotes trust, respect, and responsibility. Students and teachers alike have ownership of the learning experience in their school environment. Students collaborate on projects that require critical thinking and communication. And as you know, the furniture is a big part of this atmosphere. Barrows Incorporated of Roanoke, Virginia currently holds an existing RFP that will allow us to piggyback and purchase this furniture. The furniture will be steel case, which is exact type Turner furniture that's in there now. And they have provided a quote not to exceed $60,000. So it's recommended that a contract be awarded to Barrows in Roanoke, Virginia to purchase the additional furniture for Bingo Tech not to exceed the $60,000, and this will be pending availability of funds.
It's anticipated that once purchases will be received and then placed at Starley next school year?
Yes, sir. That's correct.
Is the same furniture that we have bought from named Vista Academy?
No, ma'am. Different vendor for that. That was a different group.
Is this furniture, is it like that with a lifetime warranty?
It is not, no ma'am. That furniture was quite a bit expensive. The reason we were able to do Warrior Tech was there was a program that they offered that helped reduce that cost at the time, a one-time program to follow up on. This one does have a good warranty on it, but it's not a lifetime like we have there.
So why are we needing to replace the furniture after 1 year?
It's not replacing. I'm sorry. It's just additional furniture. What we did, we accommodated the students that started off Bingham Tech last year, and as they're adding a new class, we want to put more furniture in.
Just because we're going to have a whole additional class.
Yes, sir.
We anticipate this will be all that's needed for the whole program, correct?
That's correct. That's our plan for it. Just like we did in Magna Vista in stages, we looked at Bingham Tech in stages as well.
Move to approve.
Second. Motion second to approve the purchase of additional furniture for Bingham Tech Academy. Any further discussion? All in favor, if you will raise your right hand.
Yes, the reason we met tonight is because we have more students here, because we usually do the evening meeting in June and no one's in town, so that's why we did our recommendations tonight. But I'm happy to report I have my highlights for the month of April, lots of good things to share with you. The first item, Rockets Way. Fifth grade students at Axon Elementary recently had the opportunity to attend a STEAM show at Magna Vista High School. Magna Vista students conducted a STEAM magic show, showed fifth graders from around the district how to make paper rockets and allowed them to ride a hoverboard they created in this collaborative STEAM event within the Magna Vista zone. Royal advice, Ms. PHCC, Demi Richardson, recently visited the Gentlemen by Choice Club at Campbell Court. Richardson, a Bassett High School graduate, spoke to the gentleman about taking pride in oneself and how the decisions we make today can affect the future. An excellent idea. Johnsville Primary students and their families enjoyed a fun April evening hunting eggs that spelled out spring. Students cracked open each egg to find sight words that they read to a faculty member. All participants carried home a book to read and a bag of candy to share and enjoy. Generation celebration. To celebrate families and grandparents, Dre Mason Elementary family members were invited to share in special activities with their students this month. Many students invited their grandparents to enjoy a special lunch together in the cafeteria at school. Before and after, parents and students at GW Carver were invited to play bingo to win books and other instructional prizes this month. After enjoying pizza and bingo, families and students in grades 3-5 participated in a workshop on SOL review materials and test preparation. BINGO. John Red Smith Elementary's PTO hosted a basket bingo in April. Parents, students, and community members were excited to play bingo to win a basket filled with various themed items for their families to enjoy. Creative lessons. April brought warm temperatures and creative STEM lessons for Mal and students. Students in primary grades constructed houses for peeps, graphed jelly bean colors, and matched eggs with sums and differences to corresponding addition and subtraction sentences. Fifth grade students were challenged with grammar task cards and math problems that challenged them to review important concepts that they prepare to demonstrate mastery of skills during the month of May. Real life math. Rich Acres Elementary students and families enjoyed solving real life math problems during family math night at the local food line this month. Students were required to use their critical thinking skills and collaborate with their families to solve problems at their level as they navigated through each school. STEM challenges. Sanville teachers and students shared STEM-related skits, songs, and poems to open their family STEM night in April. During the event, teachers ran STEM stations while families visited to learn coding, explore 3D printers in action, and experience Mickey engineering activities. Tours of the school's new greenhouse were offered by the fifth grade team as well. And by the way, I visited their greenhouse yesterday. It is incredible, and it's filled with plants already, so if you get a chance to check that out. Playing to win. Playing around recently in Mrs. Morris's classroom at Stanleytown was not only encouraged, it was required. Fourth grade students were recently challenged to create their own math games for review with classmates. To kick things off, Mrs. Morris played the theme from The Price is Right and showcased her smart board version of the game. Soon, games like Math Warriors, Rainbow Math, Math Party, and Ladder to Success were created by the students to review concepts such as factors, multiples, multiplication, division, fractions, decimals, probability, and place value. Crime scene investigation. While reviewing inferences, students at FC Middle School worked together to draw conclusions about what happened to a victim while completing a crime scene incident report based on the evidence found that led them to conclusions about what might have occurred in a staged incident. The practical application of inferring from a text brought the concept to life for participants who will use the skill on the SOL test this month, of course. Read, Rave, and Robotics. Lower Park Middle School parents had the opportunity to watch robotics in action as students programmed robots during the recent Read, Rave, and Robotics event. Students visually mapped out routes and programmed robots to travel the specified routes to control distance and rotations of robots. Students and teachers wowed the audience with iMovie book trailers, book talks, and prepared keynote presentations during the event. Art for a Cause. In conjunction with Julia Scales of the Southside Virginia Survivor Response Center, the Bassett High School Art Club created a piece of art that represents the comforts of classic Disney movies and nature. Students spent a total of 20 hours completing the screen, which will be used at the center in a children's play area. And congratulations to GW Carver's Michael Gregory, who was recognized by a parent with the Superintendent Starfish Award this month, and we surprised him coming out of lunch. He wasn't expecting to see us that day. Mr. Chairman, members of the board, we have other reports that are included in this section. I'll be glad to answer any questions at this time.
Any questions on the superintendent's Monday highlight report or seasonal expenditures, management facility report, teacher cabinet, membership report, discipline summary, or fundraiser school finance superintendent? In our membership report, I noticed that there's quite a bit of fluctuation from month to month, and we ended with a total of 7,112, start 7,086, our high was 7,169. We know that parents are moving in and out. There was any big reason for the fluctuation or month?
Good evening, Mr. Chair, members of the board. The fluctuation, I think, is something that happens typically throughout the year. It seems this time of the year there are parents who move geographically. Those things that we, as much as possible, try to keep students in our zone when we've been educating them all year. There are some parents, though, that do take their students out of zone. So I think our disposition is normally, if they've been our student all year long, we don't try to usher them out the door, but there are some families that do move throughout the school year.
So we have had some transition, but the key enrollment dates for us are going to be the end of September until the end of March. And the March count, you recall what we ended up at the end of March? I know it's on the desk.
7,079
in March. But I can provide you with the key number there, but we do have fluctuations from month to month that we monitor. But the good news is we are above what we budgeted for, so that's the good news.
Hearing no questions on the report, are there any matters from the board?
Mr. Chairman, I attended the last board supervisor meeting, and
one of our local attorneys, Mr.
Reed Young, addressed the board about litter problems in Henry County. Mr. Young has been working on this for many years. The board of supervisors is working on several aspects. As a school board member, Mr. Young asked me what we do in our school system to help solve this problem, and I told him we did several things. So what I'm asking Dr. Cotton is, could we get somebody from the staff to give us a little report next month what we're doing? And I see Mr. Harrison was here with 4-H, he just left, but I know the 4-H does certain things, and I think it'd be good to update the board if we could get some publicity from the Marshall Bulletin. We can do what we can to help our governing body clean up Henry County.
Yeah, we do several things, and we can certainly update the board at the next meeting. If that's an interest for everybody, we'll certainly be glad to do that. We also, I don't know if you all remember, we had a student art contest that went on the side of one of the refuse trucks that they did. So and that was a few years ago, and we, you know, worked on some of our initiatives then, but we'll be glad to update the board next month.
Thank you. 7th, Magna Vista High School, commencing at 9 a.m. I think we sent a signal of our interest that we show to those events and parents know that we are supportive of them. Our conferences, we have student law conference on the 2nd of June, BSBA new board membership orientation on the 17th of July, and BSBA conference on education July 18th. Please let Mrs. Forbes know if you plan to attend any of those.
Mr. Chairman, we are presenting at that conference. Is it one or two?
We elected to do just the one. They asked us which we prefer. Mr. Scott and Hilton will be presenting on school-wide discipline.
Okay, we're going to present on our school-wide discipline program that we've implemented in our middle school. So we'll be one of the presenters. Our goal is to have at least one presentation at this conference each year.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to extend an invitation to my fellow board members and the general public. Patrick Henry Community College has a jazz band that's well represented by Henry County employees, students, school board members, et cetera. There's at least three band and choir directors that are involved, one retired. Mr. Lewis leads that up. We have a number of students, current students who play in that group, and past students as well. And the concert's tomorrow night at 7 at PH. In the Walker Fine Arts Center.
7 p.m. Walker Fine Arts. Okay, and something that's not on here, but I hope that we're thinking about our BSBA convention in Williamsburg in November. Trying to find out early if we have one plan to participate in the run. We would like to issue a challenge to a neighboring school district if we find out we've got someone that's running. And it comes out lawyer also.
Sure, I'll do that.
Or moving. Okay. Please let us know as soon as possible the plan so we can issue that challenge. New competition goes along with it. Okay. At this time, we'll entertain a motion to go into closed session.
So moved.
Second.
Okay. There's a motion second to go into closed session. Do I have to?
You do have to.
Yeah.
To discuss item A, code 2.2-3711. Grant 8, Grant 1 of the Code of Virginia, forming separation of personnel. Item B, Code 2.2-3711, Grant 8, Grant 2 of the Code of Virginia Student Matters. And item C, Code 2.2-3711, Grant 8, Grant 7 of the Code of Virginia Legal Matters. The motion, do we have a second?
Second.
Motion is second that we go into closed session to discuss the items. All in favor, please raise your hand. Okay, at this time we'll entertain a motion to return to regular session.
So moved.
Second.
The motion is second that we return to regular session. All in favor, indicate by raising your right hand. Good. This time we'll have certification of closed session.
Where the School Board of Henry County has convened a closed meeting on this date pursuant to an affirmative recorded vote in accordance with the provisions of the Virginia Freedom of Information Act. Whereas Section 2.2-3712.3 of the Code of Virginia requires a certification by this school board that such closed meeting was conducted in conformity with Virginia law. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the School Board of Henry County hereby certifies that to the best of each member's knowledge, only public business matters lawfully exempted from open meeting requirements by Virginia law were discussed, and only such public business matters were identified in the motion by which the closed meeting was convened were heard, discussed, or considered. Mr. Alker?
Yes.
Dr. Duvall?
Yes.
Ms. Flanagan?
Yes.
Mr. Martin?
Yes.
Mr. Milner?
Yes.
Dr. Stanbaugh?
Yes.
And Mr. Zayas?
Yes.
At this time, we'll entertain a motion for approval of the personnel report and reassignment.
I
Mr. Chairman, I move we approve the personnel report and the reappointment list as presented.
Second.
The motion is second that we approve the personnel report and the reassignment list as presented. Any discussion?
Second. All?
Second. All in favor, indicate by raising your right hand. We did it right. I apologize. You already had a second. Okay. Now, this is the hard one. Motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
Okay. At this time, Dr. Cotton would like to give us some information.
Yes, Mr. Chairman, I just wanted to recognize that based on the approval for tonight, we have several administrative appointments that I'll just mention quickly. Mr. Joshua Bocock will be the assistant principal of Bassett High School. Mr. Charles Burrow will be the principal of Magna Vista High School. Mr. Corbin Campbell will be the assistant principal at Magna Vista High School. Mrs. Larissa Hairston Penn will be the principal at Fieldale Collinsville Middle School. Mr. Michael Minner will be director of secondary instruction and student assessment. And Mrs. Sherry Whitlow will be the lead supervisor for transportation. So congratulations to all these administrators. Thank you.
To adjourn. I guess I'll stand up.
Did you vote?
You didn't vote?